Hey everyone, this is Juno with Detour Shirts. In this video, I'm going to talk about finding trends with Merch Informer. Let's go. All right, so here we are on Merch Informer. But before we start, for those that are new to the channel, my name is Juno. I'm a graphic designer, I'm a t-shirt seller, designer. My channel is all about helping you learn to design and sell t-shirts online. So if that's something you like, please feel free to like and subscribe this video and watch more of my videos. I have a bunch of them in there. And don't forget to click that notification bell so that you can be notified when there's a new video that I put up. So here we are in Merch Informer. I honestly don't use a lot of applications for my t-shirt business, but this is one of them. So Merch Informer just has a lot of stuff here. Like, we're not even going to go through all of these, but you can see here what a great value. It has all these different things, and on Merch Informer, they have videos if you don't know how to use it. If you're not watching this video or need to know something else that we're not going to cover today, they have videos right here. Like, you can just learn about Merch Informer on Merch Informer. And I've talked about this before, this Merch Informer graphics. Like, just this alone is worth the pay of Merch Informer. Like, they give you graphics every month. Look at that, from back in November 2019. Every month, I think it's 500 or something crazy like that every month. So just maybe it's 100. Maybe each one of these is 100. But you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Every month it's more and more and more. So just that alone pays for it. I have a discount if you don't have Merch Informer already. I have a 20% discount. It's in my profile in my description, I'd say. It's just Detour Shirts, all one word, and you can put that in and get 20% off if you don't have Merch Informer already. There are two things that I'm going to talk about today, and that's this right here, Trend Hunter. We're going to talk about trends today, and then Competition Checker. So along with finding the trends, you want to know what the competition is too. So you don't only want to know what's selling, and Merch Informer will tell you what's selling, but you also want to know what the competition is. Is there a lot of competition? Should I go after this? Is it a good one? So let's go through this really quick here. Trend Hunter, I'm clicking on here right here. And first, under Trend Hunter, there's two sections. The first one is movers and shakers. So let's go to there, and I'll explain to you what this is. So you'll see right at the top here, I'm going to just use the category of Merch by Amazon shirts, but you can do t-shirts and hoodies and all the different categories like that, and also search the different marketplaces. So right now, just US, UK, DE, but I'm sure that they're working on adding the new ones. And then daily, weekly, monthly, I'll show you what that actually means. So first, it's daily. By default, it shows by daily. And what movers and shakers are saying is that the BSRs, the bestseller rank, right, is going down in a day. So these are the ones that went down the most in a day. So that's why it says daily. It says daily progress. It says 2 million. So it went down. You can see here, it went from this sales rank all the way down to this sales rank, right? So that moved really quickly in a day. So again, you'll see right here. So what you want to see is just a drop on this right side. You're going to see it drop down because the higher BSRs are at the top, the lower BSRs at the bottom. So what that means is it dropped down, right? So you can see all of these. You see that drop right here, that dropped right there, right there. So what this telling you is these in the last few days or so had a big drop. So maybe they're trends. You might want to look at that. So very nice how they laid it out. And this is the one that got the most, all the way down to the one that the least. But all of these, like you see here, dropped. So what I would do is I would look like, is this just a one-off? Is this just a one-off that this is doing well? Or are there multiple ones of these that are doing well? So that's kind of what this is helping you do. So let me scroll back up again. Now remember, there's three types here. There's daily, weekly, and monthly. So let's look at monthly, and we hit search. They're going to be different because this one had the biggest drop last month over the last 30 days. So you can see here still a drop, but it's a drop from here to here. You can see here over the last month. So not just like a drastic drop. The drop could be like in the middle of the month it dropped or somewhere else. So they still had drastic drops, but over the month, over the last 30 days, these were the biggest ones. So again, you can check. We saw this already because this one also had a big drop in one day, but you can see it, all of these have some kind of drop here. So that's just telling you what the drop is saying is it's possibly a trend because it sold a lot in the last few days. It just all of a sudden for some reason it's selling a lot, right? So that's possibly a trend. And again, the last one is monthly. So let me show you monthly. In the last few months, or wait, the last one was a week. So this one is a month. So in the last week was the other one, sorry. And this is the monthly one. So in the last month, that's why you can see this here. This is showing the last month. In the last month, it went from that to that, right? In the last month, it went from that to that. So these have a less drastic drop than the daily and the weekly. It's over the last month. So it may not be the same. So kind of interesting, right? So of course, it's showing all merch shirts. You can't do some of these because Disney also is in merch. You saw a Marvel one here before, but just look at some of these things and then find out if they are trending. So, and then take your notebook and write them down. So like for instance, let's look at this one next. I'm gonna look at this one later, but remember this, I'll write this down. Fight poverty, not the poor. I'll write it down here in my notebook. Fight poverty. And this is what kind of what you want to do when you have this, just so you can check. Okay, so I wrote mine down. We'll check that later. So that is Trend Hunter movers and shakers, right? Movers and shakers right here. So what it's saying is in the last month or in the last week or in the last day, they had a significant BSR drop. All right, trend tracker is the other thing here. So this is basically showing which has the best BSRs in the last month, 2 months, or 3 months. They're going to be kind of the same, but let me show you what this is. So it's by average. So in the last month, let me just do a run a search here so you can see what this means. So 1 month average BSR somewhere between 0 and 100,000. So it's going to take the highest one first. So you can see here, the 1 month average of this shirt here, or this design, is a 13,000 BSR average, which is really good. And then this is the next one. So basically this is your 1, 2, 3 over the last month, right? And you can see these don't have as drastic as a drop like the movers and shakers, but they have consistently low BSR. So you may want to look at these and be like, well, these may not be trends specifically, but they are best sellers, right? So now there's 2 and 3 months as well. So in the last 2 months, which had the lowest BSR, lowest average. So again, this Trump one, no surprise, in the last 2 months, the 2 month average is still 13. So this has been selling low for two months. Let's see if it's been selling low for 3 months. I'll hit search here. And you can see the 3 month average, it's still, this one is consistent, right? And so is this one and this one. They may go up and down like this, but it's riding right along here. And you can see what they're selling at. This one's selling at 15, this one's selling at 17 here. So, and what's really cool is you can also see like their estimated sales. Like we don't know exactly how much they are selling, but this one probably sold with this low BSR 338 already sales on one shirt, on one design. So just kind of giving you some nice numbers there just so you can see like this isn't a fluke. This is like, this guy didn't just sell 1, 2 shirts. This guy sold 280 shirts, right? And again, you have to look at it like you can't do Dr. Seuss and MTV and things like that. So just be careful. Don't go in here. This is not for you to copy, just for you to get ideas, right? Of course, you don't want to copy exactly what you're seeing here. This is just getting ideas for you, like maybe a fishing, America fishing idea is really good. This guy's had a lot of good sales, you know, so take that idea and run with it and make your own idea. So Trump is doing well, for example, take that idea and run with that idea, all right? And again, you don't have to do the best sellers. Like maybe you want to look at shirts that had a consistent sale of between 100 and 200, you know, maybe not the top sellers, but maybe something, you know, that still gets some good sales. These have a 1 month average of 100,000, and you know, 48 sales, not bad. I mean, still pretty good sales. I wouldn't mind getting 48 sales on all my shirts, right? So this is just really good. Merchant Former has just gathered all this data, and so that you can see it really easily and kind of make your decisions off that data. So that's, those are those two. Trend Hunter, Movers and Shakers. Remember, I'll go back here and click it. These are the ones that have the drastic drop that, you know, over the last day, week, or month, you can see that they did a BSR drop. And then Trend Tracker is just showing you the best sellers, like big best sellers, long, you know, these have been best sellers for a month or 2 months or 3 months. So you can just get an idea like that. All right, so that's Trend Hunter. The other thing I want to show you here on Merchant Former, again, we're not going through all of them, but the next one I think is really important with trends is this competition checker. So let's just check on that or click on that here. I already ran one earlier. So you can see here, Pluto. I just wanted to see, like, Pluto's back in. For some reason, selling a lot. You can see here, I typed in the word Pluto. It's saying that for Pluto, for that keyword, there's 140 products with that word in it and 81 with a BSR. And it's giving me a rank based on these things, this keywords, this total products and thing. It's giving me a score, A being the highest and B next and C and so on, and F being don't go after that. So B, pretty good. I mean, if you want to get some good sales, this is probably a good one for B. And you can see here, it will, when you scroll down, it will tell you that, like, the best seller. So you can see here, this Pluto shirt has 65 estimated sales, which is pretty good, you know, 52 sales for this one, 20C. So this isn't a fluke. Like, you want to check this as well. Like, well, Pluto, it's giving me a grade of B. Let's see what the competition is doing. Well, they're getting sales, and there's selling here. So you can see, like, these are all Pluto shirts, right? So 14 sales, still pretty good, right? So let's try another one just so you can see how it works. Remember that one we said, I gotta spell it right. Fight poverty, not the poor. Remember we saw that earlier? So let's search for this. It takes a little while to search because it's gathering all this data from Amazon. And so sometimes it's gonna take longer than others, especially if you type in a long phrase. Well, it's telling me it's an A rating. So you gotta be careful with this. Sometimes A just means, like, well, there's 13 products, there's 12 of them, you know, all of them are getting BSR. So that means, yay, go for it. There's very low competition. But when you look at this, Fight Poverty, Not the Poor, it's only getting one sale, right? So yes, you might get a sale, and maybe it's really early. You may want to check this. So what I do is I check it up against Amazon. All right, guys, I had to re-record this part. For some reason, my video got lost on the ending part here. It just was black. So I'm re-recording this ending part, so it may feel a little disjointed, but here again, I'm showing here that Fight for Poverty, Not the Poor, just to show you that there are BSRs here. So the other screen didn't show you, like, what the BSRs were. So you can see these are kind of a higher BSR. So this may have been a trend maybe, I don't know, 2 weeks ago, a month ago, something like that. That's just what my gut feeling, because these are a little higher. I'm looking for BSRs that are like 400,000 or below, 200,000, like that. So you always want to check, even with that score, you want to check against Amazon, right? So let's go back here to the checker. I typed in Biden Harris just so you can see here, like, another score level. This one's a C. And the reason why it's a C is probably because there's a lot of saturation here. So 669 products. For Biden Harris, this keyword here, but only 105 of them have BSR. So the ratio, right, again, is the reason for the C, and also just because it's super saturated. But if you look here, they're getting a lot of sales, right? Some of these top ranking ones are getting a lot of sales. So just keep that in mind when you're judging it. And here, when you are looking for a trend or competition checker, you can also check keywords. So these are really good. Like if you're going to make a Biden Harris shirt and you say, well, it's C, but I'm going to try anyway, make sure to use these keywords right here. They're giving you the top keywords of what people are searching. So that's really important. Put that in your description. So that is it for this video. We talked about Merchant Former, the Competition Checker, the Trend Hunter, Movers and Shakers, Trend Tracker. Just a lot of good stuff here again in Merchant Former. And these are the ones I use for trends. And you can see along with Amazon just to check the BSRs against it again. So that is it for this video, guys. Hope you liked it. Sorry about the no video at the end here, but if you like this video or these kinds of videos, make sure to give it a thumbs up. Make sure to like and subscribe this video. And don't forget to click that notification bell to see more videos like this. Thanks a lot. And till next time, keep creating and keep learning. Bye.